Welcome everybody to what could be the last episode of our first Endless Legend campaign. We just took on that group of enemies, which has pretty much cleared the way to go to their castle, or their capital, which should give us a supremacy win from what the game was telling me before. We're going to end the turn. And we've got another ranger. This is good. That ranger, I do not want to cancel it. I was wrong thing. Army. Right, you can just head up and join the fray up here. This guy's going to lead the charge, and the reason for that is he can bring in reinforcement a lot quicker than anybody else. So, this army is... Oh, we're still in winter. No da. I was like, why is everyone struggling with the movement? And then I realized why. I'll merge this guy into here. Probably should have... Oh, yeah, we can do that. Neat. And he's gonna lead the charge in a moment, and we'll go for the siege, and hopefully that siege won't take too long. We've got 1.8k, still going strong. There doesn't seem to be any other forces other than some troops back here. We could build a watchtower there, but that's probably not gonna give us too much range. But the heroes are the ones that have got the massive range. Right, and that turn, Glory of the Empire's been built there. What do you wanna build next? Well, let's just build these things here. Just give you guys something to do. Neat. Still winter. It's been winter for a really long time. These guys can see me coming really slowly. They've got six guys in there. If winter ends, it'd be great, because that means we get that extra attack back. Construction has been completed as well. All right. Stuff to research. Well, let's just research the rest of level one. How about that? Just so it has something to do. Actually, probably the shaman and this guy here in case we need to do something. Buyout on units. That'd be cool. Let's do that one. That means you could buy a whole lot of units and it'd be 25% less. And we'll execute that up just in case. Level four, which is great. Is that part of the city? I can siege from here, can't I? Yeah. Negative 34. Negative 67. Right, three turns it is. End turn. I see a force. Is it moving in? It's moving in. I don't like the look of that. Another ranger has been built. And it is the last piece for that puzzle up there. And what we could do up here is, instead of building right of way, we'll cancel that. We could build the plus 60 fortification. Wrong one completely. Build these two. And then also we could build some rangers and we could buy them out. It's going to cost 809, but that just means there'll be an extra unit there, because I think these guys are going to try and come back and take one of my cities. I'd rather not have that happen. It'd be much nicer not to have to deal with that, but we're going to go for the capital. We'll lose population next turn. Where? These guys? Oh, not enough food population. Alright, that will solve that. Can watch this army move in. Is he just moving across? Seems like they're trying to join something up here. Let's chuck stuff into there. Just to have some defenses. Let's just put it that way. On these frontier towns. Level 5. Brilliant. Summer. It is over. Summer has ended. Brilliant. The guys have just stepped out of their castle. I don't think they understand the repercussions of that. Fine. Just build the roads. If you want something to do. You know there's nobody in there, bro. Are you getting out because you've realized... Oh, because they lose health over time. They have vine snakes in their army. How neat is that? Well, what's that mean? I wanted you to attack, not run around in a circle. Can I click attack? No. It's got no idea. Keep the siege on. Goodness me, I don't know what's happening here. They're truly struggling with how to attack. Let's try again next turn. Oh, that thing has nothing to build. That's kind of awkward. Just now, thankfully. Watchtower, not that watchtower in the middle, it's that same place. Build some rangers just to defend, because they've got six guys coming over. I don't want to have to deal with that. Can we just have an attack now? Yep, we're up higher levels. I'm cool with that. But I want to have an attack. No, I don't want you to move. I don't understand what's happening. No. Well, now we've just... Is there something that's preventing me from doing this? I don't know. I really do not know. I think we might have to run around for some reason. Why is that? I don't know. Oh well, next turn. They're flying in though. Like, there's no tomorrow. So at least if we're gonna siege, let's siege from this side. That means our troops are closer together. Oh, those are done. Alright. Build the, just build some of that stuff, I guess. Oh, right. There is an attack now. Oh, we actually ran out of that stuff. We've actually been going for that long. Alright, you've leveled up. Neat. You're level 9. Plus 15 attack when we've been involved in a siege. All the upkeep stuff. Oh, I definitely want the siege. That's what we're doing now. Alright, attack. Show me. It's over here. That's not useful when you're on the screen like that. So he's coming to fight us. He's coming to this guy, which is great, because we get all those extra reinforcement positions. Let's do it. We've got this thing. We've got the overwhelming odds. Let's deploy out. Now there's that hill there, which is going to be really frustrating. And that's where our reinforcement spots are. So this guy needs to come all the way over here. Oh, that's not one of our squares. We don't have that many spots to be in. That sucks. Most of ours are in the water, and we can't be in the water. I have to pull them over here and get them to run up the side of the hill. We have one unit being able to spawn in. The next turn, thankfully, there'll be a lot more. Tell these guys to move up. So you can just stay there, then you guys can move up. Oh, yeah, you can't run around? Alright. You should be offensive. Go. Those guys can fire first. Oh, I just went to a square, which is going to stop some reinforcements coming in. Thankfully, we don't have to deal with any fortification business. Well, we must have killed off the heroes before, because we would have completely eliminated their armies. Goodness me, we've been doing well. Wiping out that one arm, one stack will be great. Oh, that did major damage to these units in here. That's gonna suck. Wow, critical strike 127. Jeez, these guys are getting the rolls on. Oh, an 85. Man, these guys are strong. Okay, there's one down, thankfully. Can I have some more units move out of our reinforcement squares? We're not going to be able to get more guys in if we can't get out. Yeah, there's one group gone. Jeebus. They've just pinned us in and I can't move to the squares where they are now. I should be able to move in this next turn. At least he can move away. Alright, 63 health. There's one extra unit. gosh. Try and get to the squares where there's going to be no one. Alright, let's do this. We still don't have that hero to come in yet. Is there five more reinforcements to come? Oh, critical. But we did a critical strike, which was really good. So those guys took some damage, but they can fire from there at least. Oh, critical strike for 68 damage. That's good. They're taking some poison damage. Just letting it play out. Oh, look at all those free reinforcement slots. It's been another 4 units on the field, because currently it's just 8 to 5 units. And then once I get another 4 on the field, oh, that's 2 units wiped out then? Wow, okay, now it's equal up 5 to 5. Jeebus, that was quick. I spoke way too soon. Oh, he's still alive with 11 points. Severe damage, man, that just wipes out half of my troops. Wow, these guys could die really easily. Come on, don't get critted. Okay, good. I still got 10 points. Shaman, you gonna heal them? Yep, give a couple of them back. Alright, we got some more troops into the fray. Thankfully. We've still got one left. I want you to come over here and attack. Alright. Now it's 9 to 4. Much better odds. I like these odds. Nice crit. Nice crit. So they should probably take the ones next to them. Okay, that's going to be 9 to 3. But they're 3 fairly strong ones. Those guys are definitely going to die by the end of this turn. Those centaurs just died from poison damage. Alright, and those guys just died as well. Come on, go for the... Yep, 41 damage, nice. Maybe I should start focusing down on particular ones which are stronger than the rest. Because they're doing a great job at wiping out my soldiers. 6 to 3. Okay, now we need to start prioritizing, I think. First person to fight is you. Go for him. Next person to fight is you. Go for them. Go for them. Just going for the weaker one now. Just need to eliminate him. And you? Ah, you just heal whoever you want. Okay. So it's one that's down to 2. If we could kill this other one before it gets a turn to play, it's still got 68 left, and these guys would have to have a crit. Exactly 68. Come on, crit. Oh, yeah, boy! Perfect crit. Perfect. Okay, that's prevented a lot of damage this turn. That's great. They're down to 116. They're coming in for the shaman. But he blocked half of it. We blocked a decent amount of it. Yeah, probably about half of that. They got 4 health. They can figure it out. Cool, that's them. Now a whole lot of people are just going to take poison damage, which is a shame. Cool, he can heal himself. That's good. So once they all go back into there, we lost 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 units. It's equal. But, like, momentous as well that we're able to take that out. This guy's ranked up to level 7. Attacking during siege is great. Yeah. Oh. Let's go for the upkeep. It's probably a smart decision overall. There's no one here. There's no defense. I have 8 movement points. I can still hear the buzzing sound, by the way. Mostly because it's their capital, but my capital is now being transformed into our capital. Let's retreat back as far as we can. There is a lot of resources here. My goodness. There's a lot of grass silk. Wow, look at that. Cool. Other than just clicking on some of these, just for the point of it, like, where's the grass silk? There it is. It's in the turn. Turn 150! Exactly, look at this! I just got 3 achievements, you probably can't see those. I can quickly pop up the screen to see what those achievements are. Oh, I got 5 achievements just then. You probably can't see what I'm doing right now, it's in the Steam overlay, but if you hold with me and just listen in, I'm having a look at what they are. Okay, I just got win a supremacy victory, I won a game at normal or high difficulty against AI, I also won a game at easy, and I won a game on newbie, so I got 3 difficulties just like that. And then I also win with the Wild Wake, win Wild Walkers, so there's a whole lot of upgrades there. So I did that, complete those constructions, population has grown. There we go, you are victorious! I have won with a supremacy victory. And so we can either continue playing or go to the score screen. We're gonna go to the score screen, and here it is. So just at the end there, we managed to realize that we were probably a lot stronger than we thought we did. And once we upgraded our military, man, this was a pretty dramatic battle at the end. We were able to take out both the red and the orange by supremacy. And supremacy is an interesting way to go about taking out capitals, but I think that was a good way. I think that was a really cool campaign, and I really enjoyed going through it, learning stuff with you guys, learning how to win and what's required for that. And what I'm going to be doing, and it's probably going to be a couple weeks after this episode is aired, is I'm going to start a brand new campaign, and that's going to be based off what you guys would like to see. So what I'm going to do is, a couple weeks after this video is published, or it'll probably be straight after, and then it'll be for a couple weeks, it'll be open, is I'll be asking for essentially a lot of the major settings for this new game. What faction do you want to see me play as? What, I'll probably put it on difficulty of hard, quite a few empires, you know, like 6, 7, or 8. How many of you guys want to see like a huge world size? We were playing on a size which was 30 by 50 and huge is 80 by 120. That's ridiculously big. What type of landscapes and temperate, like there's all those advanced settings that we could look at before. I'm keen to see what you guys would like to see. That makes sense, I guess. And also victory conditions. I might turn off supremacy and see what way we want to go in for that. Anyway, guys, that was my first campaign of Endless Legend. I hope you enjoyed watching it as much as I enjoyed playing it. It's a really neat game, and I hope you check it out for yourself if you'd like it. Stay tuned soon, though, for our second campaign. It's going to be a lot of fun, and I will be a lot better at the game.